Hey YouTube, how's it going? Today is Tuesday on Generic Wedding. Alright, so last week I said I would talk about my guilty pleasure songs, and I have three guilty pleasure songs that I'm going to talk about today. We'll go from like the least, I guess, guilty pleasure to the most guilty pleasure. What I'm gonna do last is very big guilty pleasure, because if you know me, you know that I really do not listen to this music group at all. But this song is just so freaking catchy, and it's just... My hair is straight this week, so I wanted to straighten my hair yesterday, so I took the time and actually straightened it, so it looks actually really good. It's actually gotten really hot here in El Paso the past few days, so it's actually starting to feel like El Paso again, and if you've ever been to like the southwestern United States, it gets really freaking hot. The high right now is in the 80s, but I'm sure as the months go on, it's gonna get up to the 90s, and maybe even the 100s, in the summer, so yay for that. Anyway, okay, so my first guilty pleasure song is this one. Okay, this song, I don't know why I like it a lot, it's just... I don't listen to Bruno Mars. I hate Bruno Mars, I don't know why, I just don't like his stuff. He just annoys me. His music just is just very annoying to me, and I've never liked that kind of like white guy with acoustic guitar music. If I want to take a phrase from Todd in the Shadows, I know he's not a white guy, Bruno Mars, but that's what he calls this. That's what Todd in the Shadows calls this kind of music. Is white guy with acoustic guitar music, and Bruno Mars makes that kind of music. I think the number one reason why I like Locked Out of Heaven is because it sounds just like The Police, and I love The Police. I like any Police song. If you don't know who The Police is, it's Sting's band that he used to front in the 80s, and they're a really good band, and they sound very... I don't know, I wouldn't say tropical, but they have that distinctive sound, and this song sounds like a Police song. And, I don't know, I really like this song. I like listening to it. I will play it over and over and over again in my room, while I'm on Tumblr, and... while I'm looking at a bunch of different blogs and stuff, so. Locked Out of Heaven, that's one of my guilty pleasure songs. Second guilty pleasure song I want to talk about is this one. Yeah, you kind of could already tell that Call Me Maybe was going to be on this list of guilty pleasure songs. I don't know what it is about Call Me Maybe. It's just, it's so addicting. This song and the next song are on Just Dance 4, and I recently played that game for the first time. I have the game now, and I love it. It's such a fun game. And I think just dancing to these songs just makes them very guilty pleasure-ish, you know. And so, Call Me Maybe, I mean, it was a guilty pleasure song when it first came out to me. Like, I sat there with my headphones on in the middle of the building I'm sitting at school, and just listening to Call Me Maybe, and I was like, thank God nobody can hear me listen to this song, because if you knew me, and you knew I was listening to this song, you would be like, what are you doing? Why aren't you listening to, you know, Panic at the Disco or something, you know? I don't know, it's just a very catchy song. If it comes on the radio, it's one of those songs you just have to dance to, or you have to sing, because you know all the words, because so many people have heard this song, have played this song. It's just a very catchy song, and I don't think it's ever gonna go away. To be honest, it's never going away. Call Me Maybe's never going away. When they do a countdown thing of the most, you know, top songs from, you know, this generation or whatever, or they do another I Love the New Millennium thing on VH1, they're gonna talk about Call Me Maybe. I know they're gonna talk about Call Me Maybe. And they're gonna talk about the video, because the video is really, actually very funny. Yeah, I remember the first time I saw that video, I was like, did not expect it to end that way. And the last song is this stupid frickin' song. You're insecure, don't know I know. You didn't expect a One Direction song to be on here, but it is. It's on Just Dance 4, and I don't know what it is about this song. I don't listen to One Direction at all. This is the only song I've ever listened to multiple times by One Direction that I wasn't forced to listen to, because I have friends that love One Direction, and they're kind of psycho. Love you guys. Oh, this song is just so addicting. It, like, I have to dance to this song every time I hear it. And I don't know what it is. It's just a very catchy song. The lyrics very addictive to listen to over and over again. I mean, it's not even that great of a song. Just the song, it's haunted me since I've played the freaking game and I can't stop. Just an addictive song. And that's not how long it's ever gonna go away, you know? When One Direction, like, you know, stops making music at some point in the future, because bands, you know, they're not gonna go on forever, like the Rolling Stones. I don't think everyone's gonna be that, volatile and versatile, like they are. So, you know, not every band is gonna keep going for the next 4 years. I hope bands like this could do, though, and Fall Out Boy. But, you know, One Direction, they're gonna maybe at least do something else. But that's probably the song that they're gonna be known for, is that song, because that's the song that got them big in America, I think. Pretty sure. Anyway, yeah, that song, very addicting. Can't stop dancing to it. I highly recommend you guys play Just Dance 4. It's a very good game, makes you sweat a lot. But that's a good thing, because you're burning calories and stuff while you dance. And yes, I'm in my bathroom again, because it's spring break. I'm on spring break. Woo! All I've been doing is watching the Avengers cartoon and movies on Netflix and being on Tumblr. So that's really all I've been doing for the past, like, 3 days, which I don't think it's a bad thing. So I'll answer Riley's questions, and her first question was my favorite condiment that I put on stuff that he put condiments on, and I guess it's ketchup, because I like to put ketchup on basically everything. On my hot dog, that's like the only thing I'll eat on a hot dog, unless it's a chili dog, then just chili, but like a regular hot dog, just ketchup. I put a lot of ketchup on my hamburger. I have mustard and pickles on my hamburger too, but mostly ketchup. Fries, I dip them in ketchup. Sometimes chicken nuggets, if I run out of like barbecue sauce, I'll put them in ketchup. Sometimes I eat potato chips in ketchup, and I know this sounds really gross, but it's actually really, really good. I don't want to try those ketchup flavored Lay's from Canada though. That's a little bit too extreme for me. And my second question that I got was my favorite beverage. Well, I'm from, like I said, I'm from Texas, and Dr. Pepper was invented in Texas, so I'm a Dr. Pepper drinking girl. I love Dr. Pepper. It's so good. It tastes very delicious. If I go to a restaurant, I'm probably ordering Dr. Pepper or maybe even lemonade, but it's mostly Dr. Pepper. Here are my questions for Sarah for tomorrow. Number one is, what is your favorite TV show? Number two is, who is your favorite actor or actress, or favorite actor and actress? And number three is, what is your favorite song? Okay, so next week you will see me. It'll be the last Tuesday of this month. So what I'm going to be trying to start doing is, every last Tuesday of the month, I'm going to do a little kind of video called Why I Love Blankety Blank So Much. And since Doctor Who is premiering Series 7 Part 2 next Saturday, I'm going to talk about why I love Doctor Who so much in my next video, because if you didn't already know, Doctor Who is my favorite TV show. And maybe I'll show you all the Doctor Who stuff that I have, because I have a lot. I hope to see you guys next week. Don't forget to favorite this video, like it, subscribe, comment, rate, and follow me on Tumblr. So I'll see you guys next Tuesday. Bye!